Mm-hmm. We are the favorite show of the meth cooks out there, apparently.
I'm wearing my cooking glasses.
Welcome, guys. This is Behind the Bunker, episode 80, at beautiful East Point, Michigan. That's where we moved the studio tonight. You like that? We have a jam-packed studio tonight. Most of the people in here we invited, some of them we didn't, but we'll get through it tonight. My name is Todd Ansich. I am your host here, as always, at Behind the Bunker. This is a weekly paintball show. If you're tuning in for the first time, welcome. Beside me is Josh Zubrickas.
Good evening.
Mm-hmm. Beside him is Joe Kimson from Flygutters Paintball.
Greetings.
And Gavin Sharma from Terratech Industries.
Salutations.
On the couch, we have the most people on the couch we've ever had before. A-Train from Track 21. We also have Christopher Hazard from Track 20. And who else is on the couch do we have tonight?
Pebbles.
That's right. And Pebbles doesn't have a mic, so she's going to talk really loud when she does want to talk. So welcome, people, on the couch.
And a small lassie.
Now, in Studio C, we have a small addition this today. We have Sarah, Justin, and Bill, all the way from Michigan to join us today. Very nice. Thank you guys for coming up.
That's not just Sarah. That's Ms. Katchak.
Ms. Katchak, 2012.
You were stealing my thunder. We were going to have a big segment with fanfare. I had confetti planned, but you know what? Okay, there it is. Ms. Katchak.
Oh, sorry. We were playing with that in the parking lot before.
Yeah, so cut that. So, guys, tonight, the topic of the show is, if there was one thing that you would do to practice to get better at paintball, what would that one drill or tactic be? So we're going to discuss that amongst all of us in the panel. We are going to be giving away a beautiful Murdertron t-shirt tonight to one lucky viewer, but it's not going to be given away to a live viewer. We're going to give this one away to people that are watching over the course of the week. So next week, we'll do the actual draw. So all of you that are watching and rewind that keep complaining that they're not winning the shirt, here's your opportunity. So we got lots to get to on the show tonight. Matt, actually, we have a picture of the last winner, don't we, there? There we go. That is Dave Johnson. He won the t-shirt not too long ago. And that's him wearing the t-shirt, not the tortoise he's straddling.
Yes. And actually, I'm under the impression that they're going to take equestrian events out of the Olympics and they're going to substitute tortoises.
Yeah. So I'll slow things down a bit.
Something to look forward to for Brazil.
Yeah. So, guys, we've got lots to get to on the show tonight. Why don't we get right into it? Why don't we talk to Clint from 300 Feet Per Second? He sent in tonight's topic video. Why don't we get to that, and we'll come back and talk about it.
Hey everyone, this is Clint, 300 FPS. This week's topic is, what's the best thing you could do to practice or get better at this sport? A lot of people tell you different things. My personal opinion, and it's worked for me and brought my game up a level, I feel, is practicing snap shooting. Snap shooting is the most invaluable skill I think there is. You can use in scenario, in speedball, rec ball, it doesn't matter. So snap shooting, I feel, is the best thing you could possibly do to practice and get better at your game.
Hey, this is Mamba, General for the Warsaw Pact. This year's full to gap. You're watching Behind the Bunker, dumbass.
All right, very nice.
Very nice.
So why don't we go to the guys on the couch and let's see what their thoughts are. A-Train is hiding his contraband. He's only up in Canada, not to go to PRZ's event this past weekend, but to suck back as much Tim Hortons as he possibly can.
Z's American.
A-Train, what are you thinking? What's the one thing that you do or think that people should do to get better at the paintball sport, do you think?
To get better at paintball, you just need to get out there and do it. Play against people better than you and challenge yourself. Try new things. Keep your gear tight and go pick a fight with me and my friends. We'll make you better.
Very nice. Now, is there a reason why you're wearing a hat with the brim pulled all the way down?
No, you can flip it around. I'm nice. Wearing it in silent protest of losing my spot on the panel.
Well, one more comment and you'll be down to Studio G. Yes, you don't want to know where Studio G is. Chris, what are you thinking?
I think just practice, left and right. You don't want to be stuck just on one side. And like Train said, both sides, and just practice against people better than you. It's the only way to get better. It's really the only way. I play all the time. That's how I got good.
Yeah. Knock on wood. Well, that's, you play all the time.
Pretty much, yeah. Yeah.
Very good. Well, why don't we move on, guys? We have a quick video that I want to show you. This was submitted by the Paintball Ninja. This is a quick promo video for Air Ups Bunkers. Stay tuned over the next couple weeks. We are going to be doing a giveaway with Air Ups once we get our promotional stuff together. But check this out, Paintball Ninja.
Airups.com does not guarantee you will become a paintball ninja simply by purchasing their bunkers. They do not currently offer an instant bunker, however, I cannot stop you from inquiring about them. Long live the player.
This is the Skeletor, 262!
This is the Hulk, you're watching behind the bunker!
Woo!
Puny human!
Poor Skeletor. Poor Skeletor. We actually saw the Hulk on Custom Corner not too long ago.
Yeah, it was Hulk gloves and mask.
You know what? Custom Corner, just to tease it up a bit, we have probably the most we ever had on Custom Corner tonight and some good quality stuff. So stay tuned and check that out. We even have a couple of videos, so that'll be coming up in about a half an hour. So Air Ups, guys, we're going to be talking about that over the course of the show. Support packages. If you guys like what you see, I have an internet bill and studio rent due. So come on, guys, buy yourself some support packages right now. And help support the show. All that money goes to pay for our, for all our bills. Now, guys, every week I like to go into a paintball store, pick one product, show it to you guys in case you are aware of it or not. Maybe it's something that you may want out there to purchase. So check this out, and we'll be right back.
Hey guys, Todd Ansich from Behind the Bunker here. Every week I like to go into my local paintball store and bring out one product that I think is cool that I want to bring to your attention so you can maybe you can go out and purchase it yourself. It's really hot out today, so what I chose is this. This is the new Echo jersey from Vulcan. It has this is the VTAC camouflage pattern that I've chosen. Very light, you can see it has very good breathability on the back. It's got a nice slit here, so you can, if you're wearing patch, you can have it tucked in, or if you're not, you're just wearing a vest, it's still nice for when you're crouching and stuff. It gives you lots of airflow. Very cool, very light. It's got the V-neck, so it's not a small midget choking you all day with a nice tight shirt. And it also has the Velcro on both sides, so if you have something like a team patch or behind the bunker patch, you can stick that on to represent. You can put your ranks, you can put all that sort of great stuff. So very cool. I think I'm going to go take this out and try it. So check it out, guys, at your local retail store that sells Vulcan. This is the new Echo jersey in the VTAC cam.
Hello, Weasel Whackers. You're watching Behind the Bunker.
We're terrible.
That was bad.
Oh, well.
Yes, there are some whacked weasels.
Weasel watchers.
All right, so guys, thank you for watching that. If you like any of the videos that you see on our show tonight, most of them go up to our YouTube channel. Head on over to our YouTube channel and subscribe, and every video, including every week's episode, will go up there so you can watch the episodes and all our videos on your mobile apps, your iPhones, your Androids, your Motorola Flips, or whatever you guys still have out there. So check that out. Dustin, you have a couple press releases you want to go through real quick at the top of the hour, right?
I do. First press release I have is from Empire. They're releasing a new version of the Axe called the Axe LE. It's coming in a limited edition color, which is Stormtrooper white and black.
Ooh.
That's the first one. Same, basically the same except for the coloring is different.
Oh.
The next one I have is from JT, essentially announcing that Sacramento Excessive, including Junior Brown, Thomas Hiller, and Rich Telford are taking over JT as a product line as far as the design, marketing, and just generally running JT as a brand.
That should be cool.
Yeah.
Get some fresh influence in there.
Yeah, try to bring the brand to what it was when it, you know, it used to be the number one speedball brand out there, right? And they're trying to bring it back to that.
Yeah. You know, now, JT Empire. Just released a whole bunch of new stuff again this year. I haven't had a chance to actually look at it up tight. I believe they're coming in, but they look pretty cool. The new JT packs, the new jerseys look good.
Pants.
Always been a big fan of their pants. So yeah, hopefully we'll see more of that in the next little while. Awesome. What else you got?
The next one I have is the paintballshow.tv. It is a paintball show essentially on, I'm assuming on TV.
television.
thank you, Dustin Obvious.
Well, it doesn't give a whole lot of details as far as that's concerned, but it says Tippmann, along with NXC, is going to be the principal sponsorship. Is going to be the principal sponsor for their first year, starting Saturday, the 20th of October, 2012. It's based out of the United Kingdom, and it's set to broadcast in 32 countries, including North America and Middle East as well. So.
Good for them. This is going to be a big help to the paintball world, you know, having it on TV. Unfortunately, it's not necessarily in North America, although I'm sure we'll be able to get a feed, whether it's on the internet or something somehow. As soon as that's available, we'll definitely let you know here. But yeah, good for them. I'm really looking forward to seeing what they produce. And sounds like they're working with a slightly larger budget than
a little bit.
Than we are down here in our studio way down in East Point, Michigan. Yeah, so good for them. So guys, we're going to be giving Murdertron shirt away shortly. But people keep asking, what is Murdertron? If you haven't checked them out, you need to head over to their Facebook page and like them. But here's a couple samples of some of the stuff they do. That Murdertron does basically casual wear for paintballers. Here's a couple shirts right here. You can see all this on their website, and they're reasonable. They're pretty inexpensive as far as t-shirts go. So if you're looking for something to wear, you know, that's not obviously paintball, that you can maybe wear to your work and still sort of represent paintball, you should check them out. Later in the show, we will tell you how you're going to have an opportunity to win it. So why don't we move on, guys? We have Bill, who's quietly sitting in Studio C right now. Bill from Mad Frog Paintball, welcome.
Thank you.
Now, what do you think? What is your one thing that you would tell tell people that they should practice to get better at the sport?
First off, if you get the opportunity, touch Sonny Lopez, and you will get better. But besides that, practice, like A-Train and Hazard say, practice. Pay attention to what you're doing and how you're getting shot out, and change up. Don't be afraid to get hit and take chances and practice.
For sure. Now, Bill, now that we have you on the big screen there, tell us a little bit about who Bill is and Mad Frog.
Well, Mad Frog Paintball, what we do is we do portable paintball games. We don't have a brick-and-mortar building, so to speak. We travel out to your location and set up. You want to hire us out for a party, company business party, you know, birthday party,
we come out. Do you do bar mitzvahs?
We would do a bar mitzvah, definitely. Okay. Weddings, whatever you want.
Okay, very good. Now, while we're talking to the guys in the Studio C, Justin.
Yes.
I like your hair. It's very aerodynamic. Very nice. So tell us a little about you. You come with Bill?
Yes, I'm pretty much second in line, you could say.
Ah, son of Bill. So you're just waiting for the day to axe him off is what it is.
No, it's kind of...
Be honest.
But no.
Are you waiting for the family fortune to grow a bit, or are you going to let him off shortly?
No, as long as he's still out there playing with me, I'm having fun. That's all that matters.
Very good. Now, what are you thinking? What is your one drill or one thing that you would tell people to do to get better at paintball?
Pretty much what everybody else has already said. You know, don't be afraid to go up against the bigger guys, the guys that'll shoot faster than you could say. I mean, shot a few times. Takes practice.
Yeah, for sure. Sarah, what about yourself? We're going to come back to you now that you have the microphone.
Okay.
So guys, why don't we see what Colonel Mustard, he sent in a video retort. Why don't we see what he has to say, and we'll be right back.
What is the best thing to do or practice to get better at this sport?
Colonel Mustard here. Today's advice is more for woodsballers or scenario players. It's a specific drill that I call the Horde drill. That's spelled H-O-R-D-E. It's a drill that simulates being outnumbered and surrounded. The premise of this drill is that the defenders are defending a flag station that will, in the next few minutes, give them points. Basically, it takes a minimum of 5 players, 2 defenders, 3 attackers. The defenders are put into about a 30-foot diameter area, usually a building and a couple of bunkers, with a respawn point directly in the center. The attackers are outside of field of vision of the defending team, and they have 4 respawn points. The defenders, their rules are basically they stay within that area, they work together. They can only respawn 1 time apiece, and if they are eliminated at the same time, the drill is over. So it's all about teamwork. The attackers, on the other hand, can be eliminated as many times as necessary for the drill to be complete. Run this a few times, that way each person that's participating gets a chance of running both sides, attack and defend, and you get to work with different people. You can randomize it if you want to. So it's a teamwork slash communication drill on both sides, and it's a see how long I can last drill for the defenders. That's my advice, guys. Just practice some drills.
Tomcat Cunningham, keep watching behind the bunker.
That was awesome. Now, Colonel Mustard,
I have to interrupt here.
Yeah.
Barney, I'm watching the prompter, and Barney makes a great point. Practice makes perfect, but when people make great moves or stupid moves, you should learn a lot when reffing. Getting a player out to ref, that's another way to learn the game a little better.
For sure.
You get to see it from a different perspective. You don't have that tunnel vision.
Now I'm going
to
pause you while Matt's got that camera up. We're sponsored by Empire Paintball, as you guys can clearly see, not Moose Knuckle Canadian style. So. Very nice.
Yeah, here we go.
And good video, Colonel Mustard. I like the green screen, and hopefully next week it won't be raining like you're calling for.
I hope Katchak doesn't do a Marineland commercial in a Speedo.
So very nice. Matt, we're going to skip ahead, and we're going to go to our next feature.
Big boy words.
And Todd caught me napping and actually enjoying the show rather than paying attention.
It's listed as point number 5.
Team feature this evening, folks, is Team Acadian. And today they have 52 members on the roster.
Whoa.
And they are an everything paintball
that's
team. They are woodball, speedball, airball, ekball, wreckball. They are paintball anytime, anywhere. They have men, women, kids, old farts. We recruit anyone with a genuine passion for the sport and proper attitude.
And a pulse.
And a pulse. They've played games all over the states, Wisconsin, Minnesota, Illinois, Indiana, Oklahoma, Oregon, Splat Tag, a bunch of different fields that they play at. This year they started to a dedicated tournament team under the same name, and they hope to grow more the next year in the area. And you can check them out on Facebook, folks. That is Team Acadian, AKKADIAN.
Yeah.
Very nice.
So guys, you want to be on Team Features, send in your info to show@behindthebunker.com. Send your picture of your logo, your sponsors. Let your sponsors know you're on a nationally syndicated internet program, whatever you want to spin it. But tell them you're on Behind the Bunker, and that'll help get some brownie points and maybe up your sponsorship for next year, right? So definitely take care of that. So show@behindthebunker.com. We've got so many things to get to. Why don't we have a look at some of these quick picks? Here's a bunch of pictures that guys have been sending in, so I'm just going to lump them real quick and we'll go through them. A-Train, you might have to help me with this.
That's who did it. Dang it.
Whose gear bag is that?
That's my trunk, and that's Swami Greg Muller from
nice.
Valken.
Very nice. The newest correspondent for Behind the Bunker, I understand.
Really?
Yeah, he's got a Behind the Bunker stencil he's working on. Now he's tagging everyone else.
Very good.
Yeah, so you have to wait and see. His check's still in the mail, but... Yeah. Very good. So I like to see guys pictures of you when you're watching the show. This is CJ. She's watching with her significant other that she met on Plenty of Fish. As with typical Plenty of Fish, it wasn't really what it looked like in the picture, but she spent the night with him anyway, so very good. Jack walked laughing 10 seconds later. This one here is T-Rex. This is the picture of her watching from home. Very nice setup. And this next one here is Swami Greg, speaking of the devil. You can see that he's playing it on his Mac and then also through his Apple TV on a big screen.
Oh, very nice.
Very nice. Very nice. We're going to have to start doing makeup if we're going to be on big screens.
Can you watch us for the Apple TV?
Yeah, because you can stream it through your computer. Huh. Mm-hmm. Maybe Joe will do a tech center next week and explain how that's done so all you guys can do that.
Maybe.
Colonel Mustard sent this picture in. This was from last week's... Very nice. And then Kelly Brennan sent in a couple pictures of her gear. You can see this is her gun all decked up with her new Behind the Bunker sponsor package. Thank you very much for your sponsorship. Your help, and then this is all her gear laid out. Now, I would highly recommend a gear bag, but she says this is how she likes to travel. So, very nice. She
rolls it up in her carpet. Like a hobo. Not that carpet.
I like Kelly, so I'm going to leave my comments alone for now. Next picture, guys. This is myself and another fellow. This was at Wasaga Big Game. This was at the Behind the Bunker booth. You can see there is the new jazz stands, gun stands in the back that maybe we'll put, give them a little more love over the next couple weeks. But
I love this camo.
Yeah, very nice, isn't it?
Mm. Looks smart.
But this leads me to my next point. If you guys are looking for Behind the Bunker t-shirts and swag, if any of you guys are heading to World Cup, we are going to be there and we're going to have all of our swag available. We're not sure where. We're going to set up at a booth. Might be one of the vendors there, so definitely come look for us there. But as it gets closer, we will fill you in on where we're going to be. So why don't we go forward, Matt? Let's see what Snarky has to say. So again, tonight, guys, is what is your one thing that you would tell people to practice or do to get better at paintball? And this is what Snarky had to say.
The best thing that you can do to get better at paintball, huh? People are bound to say to you, you gotta shoot off-handed. Or some people are bound to say, you need to practice communication. Those kinds of things, while necessary, are somewhat mediocre. If you want to get good, you gotta be fighting fit. Oh yeah, I the tiger, baby! I am the tiger!
Face to face!
And you're watching Behind the Bunker.
Woo! All right, well done. So, lots of training. A lot of people are talking about staying physically fit. Sarah, let's quickly put you on the spot.
Yes.
Sarah, otherwise known as Miss Katchak, how are you?
I'm great, how are you?
Good. Now, where is your tiara, your sash even?
I forgot it at home.
Your dozen roses.
I was scared to take it over the border.
She has a cat crown.
Very nice. So what are your thoughts?
Well, being a girl and playing paintball.
Are you?
You have to put up with a lot of the crap from the guys. So you always gotta just try and keep up with them. Lots of practice. Just if they give you crap, give it right back.
Yeah. Now, Jack or Matt, can we slightly move the cursor away from Bill's shoulder and maybe move it, maybe give him a mustache or something a little more creative, or maybe pick his nose because that would be kind of cool too. Very nice. Sorry, Bill, you drove all this way to come and just to have a cursor knock you around.
Slow clap. Slow clap time.
Very good. So, guys, why don't we quickly move into the next feature, and we'll be right back.
All right, welcome back to Behind the Bunker. This is Custom Corner. I asked last week for some customized submissions to our fans out there in paintball internet land. I did.
And what happened? We got lots. Wow.
We received many. Ooh. Our first one comes to us from Justin. He is from MPV, located in Boston, Massachusetts. He plays AG Paintball in Weir, New Hampshire. They shop at the Paintball Wizard in Paintso Army and Navy store. He watched our show live for the first time and enjoyed it. He'll try to find it out to try to watch it more often. He's sending us a submission. This is a view loader, quantum loader he had lying around. They found it in a bin at the local pro shop with an extra 140 round pod. With a little ingenuity, lots of medical tape, they created a cheap homemade version of the Plinko loader. We call it Quantico, patent pending. Anyway, this is from Dustin. Does not look good. Our next submission comes to us from Chris Maverick Ward Jr., showing off the final configuration of his Takumo Mark V. He has an ergonomic trigger guard now installed, a Tech-T I-4 bolt, an M203 grenade launcher for kicks. He'll see us in the jungle. And keep watching Behind the Bunker, so it's customized.
And he did a good job on the hardwood floor too.
He did some good hardwood.
He had shag last picture.
He did. So he's done some work with his Brazilian.
It's nice to see when they get rid of the shag finally and go hardwood.
It is sort of nice.
Nice.
Number three comes to us from Kevin Duranix of the Task Force Raider Jr. This is his modified ProFlex, or he's just taking it apart because he's letting it dry. But either way, he watches Behind the Bunker, and he likes wood.
That's sacrilegious to have Behind the Bunker upside down, just saying. It's like hanging the American flag upside down, right, A-Train?
Your GDR.
Yeah.
GDR. Next comes to us, number four. This is Patrick Boulanger, Aztec, with one of his final creations. That's pretty awesome.
He's been working outfit. Out.
He's, awesome. He looks nice. He's really buff and fit.
Shiny.
And rigid.
How many six? That's not even a six pack. That's like a 20 some odd pack.
It's a 20 pack. Yeah. Oh, Patrick. Our next comes to us direct from Eric Engler at Eric Engler Custom Products. We'll tell you about his website. This is an Engler Custom TPX. Looks like it's been painted olive green. Next is a flip top Tippmann FT12 with a real Uzi stock. Pretty cool.
Ooh.
Next is taking us back into World War II times. Yeah, this is an MP40 Phenom. So look at that, very nice. Done some work, very nice. World War II configuration. And he's also got a Dragunov sniper rifle. I'm not sure what this is built on, but who cares, it's cool. And check out more of Eric Engler's creations at anglerpaintballguns.com. You can find them on the internet. Moving right along, we have also an M2 at West Point. This is an M2 Barrett sniper rifle at West Point Military Academy, and they have their annual spring game. You can see it was in 2011.
I have some serious barrel envy.
Yes. Mm. And this comes to us from Joggernaut. It's an APC. It was built from the frame up, completely custom spec blueprints. Sealed in mind of the Velkin Corps Quebec Regional Commander Rick Morrison with an accent aigu. With the help from Team Prodigy and Dynamic, I should say that differently, Dynamic Scenarios. anyway, that was number 10. And we have a couple videos to show you from us here at BehindTheBunker.com.
All right, Joe, here's my submission for Custom Corner. Here is my axe that I use. I'm practicing today, but you can see something special about it. I had Sarge from Aaron's Army laser etched the Behind the Bunker logo on it. Nice. If you guys want to get it done, check it out. Here's his address. Thank you for putting my submission on Custom Corner.
What's up, everybody? Zuby here from Behind the Bunker. Jack and Joe's spot for the second time today. Here we go. I'm with the Juggernaut right here. Tell us a little bit about yourself.
I play for Team Prodigy.
I'm co-owner of a dynamic scenarios company, which provides scenarios for field owners. And we do custom vehicles, guns, you name it. We customize it, make it to fit for anything.
So, you came here to PRZ, loving every minute of it. You brought your own little toy. Tell me about this little puppy here.
Well, what we have here is a dune buggy with a 200 Honda 1983 200cc horsepower engine.
So no normal go-kart.
Fixated with a X7 Phenom by Tippmann with a fully customizable 900 round hopper.
And one in the chamber.
And one in the chamber.
Perfect. So we got this two-seater here. Got an own personal driver. Guys all sitting there. But why this seat so lonely?
Well, it's actually hard to find a volunteer to actually step in on the seat because you're shot at, like, completely, entirely exposing to every paintball in your direction.
Wait a minute. Exposed? Nobody sitting in this seat? Lots of action?
Lots of action.
I got a volunteer. Hang on. So I said to her, an establishment like this should probably be taking ones. You need a cash machine.
Trey.
Yeah.
I got something for you, buddy.
Oh, dude, I'm
busy. No. Fun, full of paintball.
You're in charge. Make the choices.
Well, Train, thanks for
watching. Ah, damn it, Zuby!
Well, Juggernaut, thanks for showing us the buggy. That was awesome, buddy. You are watching Custom Corner.
I'm behind the bunker. Nice. Very well
good
done.
Job. Awesome.
So and guys, anything custom, send in to showitbehindthebunker.com.
Hold on.
Oh, there's another one?
If you have fallen in love with that bunky or
bunky?
Is that monkey?
Buggy. Like A-Train did, contact the Dynamic Scenarios and you can actually rent it for your own
and personal don't trust Zuby.
Whatever. So, do you guys want to win a Murdertron t-shirt? Let's do this now. All you need to do, guys, is answer this trivia question. And I need you to go over to Murdertron's Facebook page. You can do it tonight, you can do it right now, or you can do it if you're watching it in Rewind over the course of this week. And next week we'll take all those names and we'll put it into a draw and see who wins this great t-shirt. The trivia question for tonight is Studio C. We have some guests all the way from Michigan. What company are they representing? So just put that company name on there on the Murdertron's page.
Sonny Lopez.
So put their company name on the Murdertron page, and if you get it right, we will put you in a draw to possibly win that next week. I also want to welcome all the new people watching the show. Between all the correspondents at Blast Camp and all the correspondents at PRZ or PRZ this weekend. Zed. Our numbers this weekend, I'm looking as we're watching live, we've got some record numbers and I see a lot of new faces, so thank you very much for watching, guys. Thank you very much. We're gonna move right on to another topic video.
This is
Chase, Traffic Cam. Let's see what he has to say today. Now remember, he's still on the run, guys.
Okay.
Is he?
What's up, guys? This is Traffic from the Traffic Cam. You're watching Behind the Bunker. Now, the question for this week is, what can you do to practice or get better at the sport of paintball? The only thing I can tell you on that subject is just eat healthy, hydrate, treat your body right, exercise, and that's one way you can get better at the sport. You know, get your endurance up, do push-ups, do sit-ups, and run. Now, speaking of running, I got some more to do. Myself, they're hot on my trail, but closer they get to finding me, the closer I get to finding the person who did this. But I'll try and send in a video next week if I can. Until then, Traffic out.
Check it out, it's the Midnight Angel, and he's not at CPX.
I'm at Blast Camp, and you're watching Behind the Bunker.
Very nice.
Mm-hmm.
So, we're talking about what would be the one thing you tell people to do to get better at paintball. Gavin, what are your thoughts? Have you given...
I have put some thought to it.
Very nice. Yeah. Did you put it on paper?
I did not. I committed it to memory.
On the drive here?
On the drive here. Where I actually
all the way down
5 minutes
Michigan?
After the show started, I started thinking about it. Since I play exclusively rec and big games, stuff like that, I mean, I'm not the type of guy who goes out and practices. So the only advice I would give is sort of how I learned and developed is just playing and reevaluating how you got hit if you've been shot out, and then just try to correct that the next time you go out and just play as often as possible.
Yeah.
That's it.
Joe, what are the things you think?
I think lots of different things.
Mm-hmm.
I think if you switch up the type of paintball marker you use, if you play primarily with a semi-auto or an electro semi, like a TM15 or TM7 or something like that, try reverting back to the primitive days of paintball. Go into someone's vault or into a local paintball store, pick up a pump gun. Try playing pump for a few games or a couple days, and just, you know, you'll learn a lot about angles, a lot about timing, especially when you're shooting, you're vastly outnumbered or you're shooting against people that are using electronic paintball markers. Use a pump. Use a smaller 50 round hopper on top. You'll have to really think about every shot and make sure it counts, but then you can switch back with this knowledge and this practice, and then you'll become better at what you do and you'll become more lethal.
Yeah, for sure. What are you thinking, Josh?
I would have to say keep an open mind. Try different things. Don't just walk out on the paintball field and say, oh, you know what, I'm only going to use a Milsim marker. Try something different. Try a speedball gun. Yeah, always have a safe word. Practice safe
try
words.
Wearing tiger stripe.
Yeah, try wearing tiger stripe. Don't just limit your point of view and say, this is what I'm going to do. This is all I want to do. Switch it up, because you're going to learn quickly on a speedball field snap shooting than you are playing scenario, but you know, you might move a little differently playing scenario than you do speedball. So
rhinoceros.
Switch it up, try it all. Okay. All right.
Or switch back to rental equipment.
Yeah,
rental
or play with a 98 custom that's had so much snot, boogers, and sand through it that.
I've heard. What are you guys pointing at?
Clint from 300 FPS.
Well, speak up.
Probably
what is he saying?
He said you need to Skype in Sonny Lopez. Sonny Lopez.
You know what, guys? My thoughts on this whole thing is, someone also said this in the panel tonight too, play with the big boys. Always play with people better than yourself, because that's only one way to learn. And follow these guys around. You know, you're only going to learn if you ask questions.
That's illegal.
What's that?
Don't stalk them.
Well, that's no, illegal. I'm talking specifically during the game of paintball.
Oh.
But play with the big boys, and also talk to people. You know, find out, you know, when you got, you know, when you did get finally shot, where did you get shot from? Go talk to the person. How did you get me? You know, was I sticking really far out? Was I doing something wrong? And get their opinions, because if you just walk off the field and never learn or never told what you've done wrong, it's going to take you a long time to sort of figure it out for yourself. So, you know, talk to people and definitely, you know, talk to or play with guys that are better than yourselves.
But how did Sonny Lopez get better?
Sonny
Lopez has cloned himself, so he plays himself.
Oh, okay, that makes sense.
Yeah. There's an everyday Sonny Lopez that goes around, and
I
there's
the
one
world
that just
was
practices
explode.
Paintball.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
That makes sense.
True story. Very good. So why don't we move on, guys? We have paintball around the world coming up just after this.
Hey, this is Davey with Valken. How can I help you?
Yeah, we have a full line of tournament and scenario gear.
Yeah, sure. I can get that paint out of here today.
Hey, can you hold on for a second? I got another call. Yeah, just another day at the office.
All around the world, starring me, Josh, aka Sean 2.0.
Welcome to Paintball Around the World. On the outside. Yes, if you have anything like to add to the show, send to show at behind the bunker. .com. First up tonight, the Friendship Paintball in Kiev is hosting a game September 8th and 9th.
Where?
Kiev.
In Ukraine.
From Ukraine. Yeah. Well, is there another Kiev?
There's chicken Kiev.
A place, not food. Oh. 8th and 9th of September, the pre-World Cup tournament is happening at Area 1 Paintball.
Where?
Right there on the poster on the bottom, the bottom line. Five-man woods ball tournament, September 9th at Swamp Paintball Park.
Where?
Swamp Paintball Park.
I'm getting a complaint that someone's throat is dry, so I had to do that out there in our chat form. Oh, go ahead.
Okay, there we go. Aliens of the Rockies, September 14th and 15th, Paradox Paintball. Note the Behind the Bunker logo.
Where's that? Utah.
Rocky, Utah. Dead Man's Hand, two-man limited ammo tournament, September 30th. At Long Live Paintball.
Did you put these in order?
No, somebody else did.
Oh, it's very nice. It flows well this evening.
No, it's confusing because now I got to. Everything's out of order. Breakout Kings, September 6th. What?
You're out of order. Keep going.
The whole freaking system's out of order.
At Swamp Paintball. Well, you're out of order.
Where's that?
Everybody's out of order. Swamp Paintball Park. I can't find my next one.
How's the math?
Guns for Hoses, September 6th.
Do you drive here?
Okay, next.
What's this one?
Hey, Zuby.
This is what?
You were off by a month.
I was off by a month.
You said September 6th.
October
6th.
Oh.
Wow, we get an extra month.
And that's also Hooses, right, Adrian?
My apology.
You bet.
The hoser.
Hooses. No way.
Area 51 paintball. That guy in the bottom left-hand corner floating above the earth. How did he do that?
Looks like a pro to me.
Sonny Lopez.
Maybe he knows Sonny Lopez.
Where are they?
That's going to be a great event.
I've been hearing a little bit about it. There's a lot of media around that.
That's a behind the bunker event.
Yep.
$40 for the entire weekend if you travel over 400.238 kilometers, which is 250 miles.
Thank you.
When in Rome, you do the conversion.
Yep.
It's $10 off the event, $40, $50, or $60 a case of Valken paint, or bring your own. Just 2 days of great paintball.
Huh.
And I heard Zuby's going to be there.
Nice. That's what I heard. Zuby
will.
There may be
some retribution in order.
I have to go disrespect some of your countrymen.
Bring it. Just bring friends. Pack the car. That's what paintball is about. Get to the event. We'll get behind the bunker swag. What else could we give them? We'll come up with something fun. Check the Facebook link.
Next event, Big Indian Paintball. 20th of October.
Where?
There's also the Honey Badger in that photo. Zombie Apocalypse, Zombies vs. Humans, happening October 27th and 28th. Low Country Paintball.
Where's that?
Low Country Paintball.
Where's Low Country Paintball? Where do I want to go?
We Were Soldiers 2, happening November 3rd. Where Heroes Are Born.
The first one was fantastic, guys. Check this one out. This is only going to be better than the first.
Blackhawk Down.
Okay, good to know. Blackhawk Down 6, where? November 3rd.
Where?
Yeah. No, the Vulcan Corps will be there as well.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Fold a Gap. I wish we had someone in studio who could tell us about this poster.
Ah, Fold a Gap. I'll be going to that. That's in November. A-Train, you're coming with me there, right?
You bet. That's actually on one of my team's Do Not Miss events. We went to it about 4 years ago. Everybody shows up to that. It gets bigger and bigger every year. It's a great field, great people. Hit the gym. There's not a flat spot on the field, but great scenario. A lot of mill simmers, speedballers. There's something for everybody.
But if you guys are going to that, you need to sign up and play with me, okay? I'm on the Warsaw pack, which is the winning side. So sign up for the Warsaw pack now.
I will go ahead and guarantee a Warsaw victory.
Ooh. I just may have to
I'm predicting landslide, to be honest with you. I mean, it's not going to be fun for the guys on the opposite team.
It'll be borderline criminal.
I would even tell you what the name of the other team is, but it doesn't matter. They're not going to win. Mm. So.
Sonny Lopez.
All right, well, let's keep going.
Sonny Lopez.
OXCC is presenting the Battle of the Bulge, happening Saturday, December 8th at the Outdoor Extreme and Chesapeake City, Maryland.
Oh, okay, I got it now. What coast is that on?
Just for you, Joe. It's in America land.
On the East Coast?
Yes. And Crusades Shoreline Paintball. If you are one of the 300 people that are invited to this event, I am so very, very jealous. Very, very jealous. Check it out, shorelinepaintball.com.
That event is going to be epic. And we'll have more information as it gets closer. And when I say epic, I mean when I show you these photographs, guys, you're going to want to play.
Are you going to show the photographs?
Still waiting for my I think so. I just haven't had a chance to post them up. And then you have another poster there I saw.
We do. This happens to be Act of Valor.
Boom!
Fantastic, fantastic day of great paintball if you are playing on my side. Because if you're with the poor souls named Hotspur and Gavin, well, I don't know, Gavin, are you depressed already?
No, we're gonna have a good time. Sure.
No, it's guaranteed to be a great event.
That's what all the second place teams say.
Phoenix Projects are always a fantastic show. Joe and the gang at Fire is doing an amazing job, so I'm looking forward to that one.
Gavin, when's the last game you won generally? Go ahead, I'll wait.
That would have been the July 15th event at Flag Raiders, and I came home with the win.
Very nice. Right?
Last year or this year?
This year.
All right. Now, there's a couple quick videos that we're going to play.
A couple videos.
And then when we come back, guys, we have someone that's going to Skype in and give his opinion on tonight's topic. And if you guys have an opinion that you want to talk, get on Skype. We're going to we'll take your call. So we'll be right back.
My king has sent me on a special mission. You just give us the signal. Will not survive.
Greetings, players. Be sure to join us in the Ultimate Attack and Defend game, Castle Conquest, coming to EMR Paintball Park on September 29th. Scotty, Bad Reverend Barnes, is leading the Canadian defense in this pure paintball insanity. See you there. Not this time, rabbit.
So very good. So
I think I like Rio.
I am in love with Rio.
I think it's a nice place.
Nice place.
Beautiful scenery.
4 years will be the Olympics.
Mm-hmm. Very nice. Now I have with me Matt. We can jump over. I have someone on Skype that has just called in. Hey, this is Tiger from Web Dog Radio, guys. You guys normally see him every week. He puts a weekly segment in, but this week because of his operation, he was not able to put a video in. So nice to see you tonight.
You weren't supposed to talk about that!
See, his voice is already changing, guys. I told you, as soon as they cut it, it's just... So very nice.
This layout.
That's my outside job. I don't want to talk about that here.
Yeah. So what do you think? Well, the topic of tonight was, again, what is the one thing that you promote to people to do to get better at the paintball, sport of paintball?
Well, you guys have been talking a lot about the gear and stuff, but I want to talk about just doing something mentally, because a lot of people don't think when they play. And what I'm about to say is going to sound like a lot of, you know, long-haired hippie stuff, but there's actually some hard science behind this. Visualization techniques. What you want to do is between games, or even, you know, on like Wednesday, Thursday, between the weekends, you think about the game that you just played and you kind of rewind it in your head and you think, okay, what did I do right? What did I do wrong? What could the other team have done to counter my move? And this is just some of the stuff that you can do up here. It doesn't cost anything. It's easy to do. There's lots of resources on the net to find out how to do it. So visualization techniques. That's, you know, not to take anything away from the physical stuff, but think. Use this for more than just holding your ears apart. That's what I'm getting at.
Yeah, for sure. Now, Tiger, be the ball. All right, no one watched Caddyshack? Am I the only one that got that reference?
I do.
Well, I'm not going to get on the ground and start, you know, yelling at the ball to go home either, you know?
No.
Oh, that was some different movie.
It's hard to be the ball when you keep talking like that. That was the line we were looking for, but thank you. Thank you for trying. Very good. Well, that's awesome. Now, are we going to see more from WebDog Radio next week on the show?
More than likely. I've got a helmet camera. I'm not afraid to use it.
Fantastic. Now, next week's subject, guys, is MegFed the next great thing in paintball, or is it just a trend or fad right now? And if you guys have an opinion on that, send it in either via email or send me in a video, and we may get you on the air as well. So, cool. So, thank you, Tiger, very much for stopping in via Skype. And nice. And we'll see you next week. Thanks, Tiger. Okay, so guys, we're going to go to What's Up With That? Right after these messages.
Whoa. Huh?
Comes to us from our good friend Mr. Condiment himself, Colonel Mustard. Colonel Mustard asked a question to us about just your involvement in paintball. If you wish to continue to play paintball, can you consider yourself a paintball player? So, if you don't ever play paintball anymore, should you still consider yourself a paintball player? Giving it up and still consider yourself a paintball player? What's up with that?
You know what? We have A-Train in the studio all the way from Kalamazoo, Michigan. Why don't we go right to him, Matt?
He derailed himself. He fell off the bridge. Oh, well.
Great point. Yeah.
You know what? I'll start the debate. I think if you get out of, you know, we're talking about a timeline here. A lot of people have financial issues and can't play paintball. I think if you're out of the sport for 6-8 months, maybe even a year, I've known guys that had, you know, that lost their job and get out of it. Their heart's not out of it, just their financial, you know, ability to play is out of it. But the next year, they're back at it, a little rustier, but definitely more hungry to play. And you know what? For myself personally, I've been playing strong for a solid number of years, and all I needed was a little bit of a break to rekindle my love for the sport. And I was going pretty strong for a while and took a bit of a step back this winter. Once I started playing again, that break was well deserved. So I think you can, but much more than maybe a year, I think you're pretty much, I mean, once you officially sell your gear, that's when you're officially not a paintball player.
Yeah. I was just
Joseph?
Speaking gibberish. No, our alien friends are able to understand that. I've been running Flag Graders for nearly 30 years now, and you know, I'm seeing guys that, you know, played fairly consistently for 5 or 10 years, and then, you know, they would get married, they would buy a house, they would have a family, and now I'm seeing these guys that enjoyed the sport, you know, 15 years ago, resurfacing, and they're bringing out their, you know, now they're 12, they're 10 and 12 and 14 year old sons for the first time. And these guys have always had the love of the sport and the love of the people that they met at paintball in their system. And now they're coming out and they're sharing it with their children. So I think, you know, you can be a paintball player, you can stop playing, but inside your heart, it's you're always a paintball player. It's like you're, you know, what they say in the Marines, once a Marine, always a Marine. So once a paintball player, always a paintball player.
A-Train's finally had an opportunity to compose his thoughts. He left for a moment, but now he's back. A-Train, someone leaves the sport, stops playing paintball. Are they still a paintball player?
No, there's somebody that used to play paintball. I mean, there's, in my opinion, I mean, if it's a part of your lifestyle, there's so many of us that make the sacrifice to go to a lot of different games and call our friends and watch the show and stay in touch with the lifestyle and manufacturers. They're always welcome back, but someone that played 8 years ago or hasn't played in 3 years, I'd say, oh, cool, you should play paintball again, but I wouldn't say you're a paintball player.
Now, let's say they lost their job and they don't have any money and they're not able to get out to play paintball. What is your timeline? 6 months they're out? Year they're out?
It's sort of like dating a friend's girlfriend. 3 years or 20 new hairdos, whatever comes first.
20 what?
20 new hairdos.
Oh.
It's on the internet. It's true. Wolf will confirm that.
Now, what about Studio C? We paid a lot of money to rent this camera and this studio space over in Studio C, so we're going to darn well get advantage of this. Sarah, what do you think?
I say, I mean, you know, there's differences between people that just do it just to do it. There's differences between people that do it because they love it. And there's always ways around it. I mean, you can always go back and, I mean, we'll definitely welcome you back into the sport. So, I mean, it depends.
Yep, for sure, for sure. Yeah, you can hand the mic over.
Would you ever stop playing paintball?
Sonny Lopez.
Now, see, Justin, I thought the mic was going over to Bill. That's why I suggested that.
He's got a point. Why would you stop playing? No, if you can't afford it, you know, go out to the field still and hang out. It might be a little bum you out a little bit, but you're still involved. Stay involved in the sport.
Yeah.
If you step back and sell your gear, you got to get new stuff and start playing again, or you're not a paintballer.
Yeah. And the sport of paintball needs people to play. I mean, if you're not playing, it's not helping our industry. And right now, more than any, we need this industry to get back to where it used to be 3 years ago. So if you're not playing, you're not helping. I mean, you know, if you've taken up a passion of another sport, then I guess bye-bye. But love to have you back, I guess, right?
Since it's my segment, maybe you should come to me.
Well, that's why I was looking at you.
Or it needs more Sonny Lopez.
Nice. Sonny Lopez.
All right. I think to consider yourself a paintball player, you should play at least once per season and still have the equipment. If not, you're just sort of on the peripheral of
you're just
the
a Dion.
You're just one of those people that used to hang out. But, I mean, life happens, whether that's finances or that's family or other commitments, and sometimes you can't be out as often as you'd like to. But I think it's, you know, it's been mentioned already, as long as you're part of the culture and helping to, you know, promote the sport, whether that's on the internet, hanging out at the fields, helping out, reffing, stuff like that, I think at that point you can consider yourself a paintballer. But I think you should own your equipment or have some access to it and play at least once a season in order to be considered an active paintballer.
For sure. So if I had something that was grinding my gears or irking my...
Or jamming your hopper?
Yeah.
Gavin, I got one for week. Todd just skips pause. Over me you during your comment all the time.
So. I saw that.
What's up with that?
We have a problem on Studio B. What's up?
We're in DEFCON 4 right now. Tiger.
Tiger, what's up, dude?
What?
Satellite.
Tiger in the chat forum says, who is Sonny Lopez?
Does he have a Wikipedia page?
Yeah, Jack, just cut him right out.
Yeah.
Can we get a band stick here?
Yeah.
Where's the band hammer?
Dustin.
Very nice. So, guys, I guess if you want to send in your thoughts to Gavin, send it to show@behindthebunker.com if you have something that irks you, and we'll get you guys on next week. Now, I'm going to go to our Skype. We have a gentleman that just Skyped in. Okay. Matt, do you have him? Very good. Afternoon, sir. How are you?
Who is this?
How's it going, guys?
Good. Can you introduce yourself, sir?
Yeah, my name is Justin.
Hi, Justin. How are you?
Hi. I was actually the person that sent in the picture of the Quinocchio that I made with my friends.
Ah, very good. Now, you sent me two pictures, and unfortunately, one of them was not working. So I was only...
Oh, really?
Yeah.
No, I think they were both the same thing, actually.
Ah, very nice.
But yeah, I wanted to chime in about what you guys were talking about, how you could, you know, consider yourself a paintballer even though you have not, you know, played in a while. When it comes down to it, I do think, yeah, you know, as long as you have all of your gear, you know, as long as your all of your gear is not sold off, and another important thing is as long as you have that drive to keep playing, you know, and that you know, having withdrawals from not playing for a while, as long as you have those, I think you're still a paintballer deep down, you know?
So, Justin, you're saying if I still wear a paintball t-shirt even though I don't play, I'm still a paintballer?
Oh, I'm sure. I guess it comes down to how much time that you spend away from the sport. But as long as you feel like you're part of the sport, I mean, I've always considered paintball, the community itself, to be a, you know, a close-knit one. And we're all, like, you know, one big, you know, brotherhood or something like that. You know, so I think as long as you don't spend too much time away from the sport, you still have most of your gear and stuff, I think, you know, you should still consider yourself a player of the sport. Yeah.
Now, here's a question. I'm going to throw this out to you because it's just a hypothetical, and I'm not even sure why I'm thinking about it. But let's say there's a guy who, you know, who watches a paintball program and professes to enjoy and play paintball, but they wear an NFL hat. Would they still be considered a paintball player?
Or what team is it you like? Is it Washington Redskins? What is it?
I'm actually wearing a Kansas City Chiefs hat right now.
Yep. Eyes close.
That's too
close,
bad.
Yeah.
That's too bad. Wow, I saw there just for a moment there when you took your hat off while you're wearing a hat. I'm just kidding. So welcome to the program. This is the first time you've Skyped in. Thank you very much. You're the first person to actually Skype in for us.
Where is he? Oh, you're in Massachusetts, in Boston.
Yep, Massachusetts, yep.
Very nice.
I see that here. I have your dossier. Yes.
When you open up your car, do you need your khakis? just wondering.
His khakis. Okay.
So how long have you been watching Behind the Bunker, and how did you hear about it?
I've been watching the Rewind episodes. I haven't been able to watch live until now and last week, but I've been watching the Rewinds for a little bit, probably the past 6 months or so.
Do you know that we have not been able to sleep at night knowing that you keep missing our program? And tonight, tonight I'm going to sleep like a baby knowing that you actually got a cup. Yeah, and you came live on the Skype. Very nice. What was that, A-Train? What's your favorite part of the show? Here's A-Train's way to trick you to see if you've actually been watching the show.
Well, no, it's viewer feedback. That's what this is.
A weird paintball show. That is a viewer feedback.
Yeah. So his question is, what do you like most about the paintball show that you're watching? This is Behind the Bunker, by the way, in case you need to reference it.
That's on internet.
Definitely. It's actually hard to pick. I mean, the fact that there's not too many shows like this, and, you know, we all learn a little bit from each other's, you know, experiences and stuff, whatnot. So I do think that helps and overall improves your game when you're on the field.
Yeah, for sure. For sure. So Custom Corner is his favorite, guys. He enjoys the custom gear. And
I appreciate what you guys do, and all the time you put into it surely helps the community.
Very good. Well, thank you very much, Justin, for watching the program.
No
and guys,
problem.
Anyone else
me.
Out there that wants to Skype in, we don't bite. We're very friendly. Skype in. See, Justin's enjoying himself. So guys, what we're going to do is we're going to move on right now, and we're going to check out the top news stories from...
Somebody. Who?
Is there something that you'd like to say, Josh?
Nope.
No.
There was some fist slamming, though.
There sure was.
Continue to watch.
While we talk Josh down, let's watch Gat Check, and we'll be right back.
Everybody, Tomcat Cunningham with the Cat Shack Reports Paintball News, back for another exciting edition of Behind the Bunker, Monday, September 3rd. And in this week's news, Tippmann and NXE did sponsor the paintball show. Major sponsor on board for the show. I foresee this thing being huge. Be sure to check that out on the online demand version once it airs on British television. And another news, or rather a little bit of an update, with me, the man himself, Mr. Sarge Moran of Aaron's Army. Sarge, how you doing?
Excellent, Cat Shack. How are you?
I'm good. We have been doing great things. Talk to me. What's happening with Aaron's Army?
Well, if you don't know what Aaron's Army is, it's my wife's army. It's a support group that's come together to support my wife in her fight to beat cancer for the second time. She was diagnosed with terminal cancer 6 months ago. We figured, you know what, terminal is just a word. That's the doctor's word. We figured they can't help us, we're going to find our own help. We looked inward to the paintball community, got in touch with some homeopathic doctors, got some good food, good people, good support equals good results. I'm happy to say my wife, 6 months later, tumor's starting to shrink, even if it's just a little bit. It's progress. Cancer doesn't shrink on its own, so we're doing good stuff. Your love and support's really helping. It's important more now than ever. We love you guys. Thank you. Support everything. It's just, they're really touching. Thank you very much, guys. And
absolutely incredible amount of support from the paintball community. We're talking North America wide.
North America. We had soldiers in Afghanistan message us. We sent some tags out to Afghanistan, Germany. We got some in Switzerland and Sweden. I mean, all over the world, actually. Globally, paintballers have come together to support my wife, someone they've never met. They just know that they got to help out. It's like everybody here is a big family. We talk about family. We're respecting kids, getting everyone together. It's a family sport. It's truly great. Introduce someone to paintball. It might just save your life one day.
Amen to that. Sarge Moran, these guys have done some incredible things through homeopathy.
Homeopathy, yeah.
And we are very, very pleased to announce that we're starting to see a little success with this.
Yeah, success and just good health in general. Anyone that's seen anyone in chemotherapy, radiation, it's a terrible thing sometimes. It really messes up the body. And in this case, it wasn't going to help my wife, so we needed to find an alternative. And that we did, and it's helping and it's working.
They're doing it. Keep up the great work. Keep up the great support.
Yeah, thank you guys. From the bottom of our hearts, God bless. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
It's Tomcat Cunningham with the Cat Shack Reports Paintball News. For Behind the Bunker. We'll see you guys on the field.
That's right. See?
Peace. Hey, everybody. Tomcat Cunningham with the Cat Shack Reports Paintball News. We are down here at PRZ Paintball in Picton, Ontario, and we're wrapping it up. Today, we found ourselves a little gem of a paintballer right here. Young lady, what's your name?
My name is Mouse.
Mouse, what team are you running with?
Salem Assassins.
I have some friends of mine. Don't quote me on this, Mouse, but a few friends of mine said, and I quote, girls don't play paintball. What do you think about that?
Well, guess what? I'm playing paintball right now. I'm a girl.
She does play paintball. We witnessed this firsthand. Now, I got some other friends of mine that would like to maybe step on here and show you a little something. What we got here?
Deadly Wind.
Cool. It's
barrel,
awesome.
Carbon fiber.
It's all right. Amazing.
You know who that is, don't you?
Miss Cat Shack 2012.
Miss Cat Shack 2012 right there. She's hooked you up with a brand new Deadly Wind barrel to put on that marker of yours because we want to see you shoot with just a little more accuracy.
All right. I always say girls don't play paintball, but this kid's legit. And my friends at the Valken Corps, because I'm in the Valken Corps Great Lakes, but your friends at the Valken Corps Ontario want to make sure you can keep your hair up. So my friend Rob, the regional commander, he sent that over to you to make sure everything's good. Keep playing paintball and keep promoting girls in the sport.
Hey, Trent, get back here. I want to hear what this child did yesterday. You talked to me. What did she do? We saw this firsthand.
This kid's a monster. You can put her in your pocket because there's nothing to her. But she takes and plays right with the big boys. I mean, you have to come out and play with her, and you'll have your own stories.
Over and above that, and this child right here, she's standing over there just in the staging area. A couple of adults come off this field with no barrel bags. This one right here says, hey, what are you doing? Put your barrel bag on. That was awesome.
Well, it's not just that you said it, it's how you said it. It's like a true ambassador of this game. She really takes this sport. This is your sport, right? You got to take ownership of it, and we're all really proud of you. You really impress us every time and remind us what we all need to be doing, Mouse.
Ladies and gentlemen, the next generation of paintballer right here. Mouse. Peace.
Team Shadow Ops here. We're from Illinois, basically.
And you're watching Behind the Bunker.
Woo! All right. So, guys, we got lots more on the program. We're going to do a quick recap video of Blast Camp from last week. Now, this is this one got double teamed, right, A-Train? This was a Track 21. And a Skeletor 262 production. For those of you that weren't paying attention,
no,
I'll do
actually,
that again.
Gosh.
So we're gonna
get off the
shortly.
Belt. Though Skeletor actually has some really. His, if
techniques.
You haven't checked out his, ding me like three more times.
gentle.
I swear to God, I'm out of here.
Now he's just haunting us.
So Skeletor has some really great game footage. You know, my stuff's always a little campy and chirpy, but you know, you even CeCe's a subscriber to Skeletor 262.
Absolutely.
So his video on his channel is really great game footage. Just something a little different. I got stuck.
Yeah. And you know what? It's a good video. I watched it, and you guys are going to want to see this. And then we also have a video from Skeletor. He went and played street ball with the HK Army, so we'll check that out near the end of the program. But Skype is on fire tonight. We have Barney from the Blues Cruise. Barney, how are you?
Good. But Skype is on fire tonight.
Barney, if you're listening to me in delay, shut your behind the bunker window and just put Skype up.
He doesn't.
We'll give him a couple of seconds.
If you're listening to me delay, shut your behind the bunker window and just put Skype up.
Three, two, one. Barney!
I got it.
There you are.
It's driving me crazy.
Yeah, shut the behind the bunker window so we don't get your feedback. Yeah, mazel tov. Nice to see you tonight. So the topic of conversation tonight is what is your recommendation to help get players better in the sport? What are you thinking?
Well, I posted, and I thank A-Train for making a point of my point of being a ref. You learn so much. I agree with everybody talking about, you know, snap shooting and playing with better players, but those players are already in an intermediate stage. So if you're already practicing the snap shooting and all that stuff, that's, you know, you've already gotten involved in paintball. But if you're a newbie or a regular player and you want to learn, ref. When you ref, you get, you know, see great players, experienced players, new players, and you get the scale. You can see them make great moves. You can see players make dumb moves. And if you're an intermediate player or an experienced player and you're reffing, you can see the development. You know, when guys are making moves, you can see before it happens, you know what's going to happen. As a ref, you put yourself in a position to make the call. But while you're doing that, you're just learning so much. The experience is amazing. I mean,
yeah.
I would say my experience at the ref, which I did for 10 years, it's amazing. You know, you just learn from so many levels of.
And you know what? That's a good point. And maybe one of these shows we'll do an offshoot topic of this, and it would be, you know, as a ref, what's the stupidest thing you've ever seen on a field? But, I mean, I think we've all on the panel for sure have reffed. A-Train, Chris Hazard, I'm sure you guys have reffed an event, right?
Oh, yeah.
I mean,
it's where I learned the importance of the whistle.
Yeah, I mean, you sort of get to see the forest for the trees because you get to see what people are doing that's working because they're the ones advancing up the field, and you get to see the same stupid mistake people make time and again that you shouldn't be doing. And, good point, Barney. Thank you for being on. Now, where are we going to see Barney next? Are you going to any big games?
I just did a tournament at PSI at Waldo Red. It was a wood bowl tournament this past weekend.
Yeah.
I haven't done that in like 10, 12 years. It brought back so many memories. I had a great time doing that. I'm going to be doing more wood bowl tournament next year. I'm definitely going to add more of that. My next event will be with the crew. We'll be at the Tippmann Challenge in Michigan. I'll be at the Fort Castle Conquest game, probably the West Point game. I'm looking down the line to October in OXAC. I'll be at Waverly's game. She's generaling. And then later on that year, which is a Viper game, actually, that OXAC game in October. And then in December, I'll probably go down. No, definitely going down to Wayne's World with the crew for the grand finale. And then the week after that is OXAC again. I'm going to be XO-ing.
Okay. Now, Barney, when I asked the question, I was kind of looking for maybe the next date you're coming, maybe just one, maybe two. But that was a lot of dates. You're going to be a busy fellow in the next couple months.
It's the last 2 years, I did 27 games. This year, I cut down a little bit, so I did 20 games, which I get ragged on, which I understand, 20 games,
For sure. Well, listen, I'm going to cut you off, Barney, because we got a ton to get to tonight. Thank you very much for calling in, and now that you have my number, call in any Monday night that you want.
Oh, I'm looking forward to come back up and Flag Raiders and to the show. I got to talk to Noah. He's a partner in crime when we do the long trip, so I'll definitely be up there again.
I don't mind you coming, Barney, but maybe find someone else. No,
okay, I will find somebody.
I'm just kidding. I'd love to have both you guys back up. But anyways, I'm going to let you go because we're running out of time. My producer keeps tapping his watch. But thank you, Barney, and we'll see you again. Thanks, buddy. All right, guys, so we're going to move on. Matt, I would like to take our show on the road. Can we do that? Alright guys, so Behind the Bunker, if you want to see any of us at Behind the Bunker at your local event and to promote your event, let us know. We are going to be on the road this weekend, September 9th. You can see Chase, Traffic Morris, he'll be at the Swamp in Gloucester, Virginia. September 22nd, you find Colonel Mustard, he'll be at Boss Paintball in Locust, North Carolina. September 23rd, you can find myself, Joe, Gavin, Zuby, Wolf, the Honey Badger.
Oh, I won't be at that game.
Honey Badger will not be there. So guys, there's another reason to come to the event, as well as Cat Shack will be at Flaggers Paintball for Act of Valor. Sorry, Chris, I didn't know you were coming.
It's okay.
September
Gavin
30th.
You can Gavin needs a chance to win.
Yeah. September 30th, you can see Chase again in Maryland. October 6th as well at the Swamp. And on the 7th as well. October 13th and 14th, you can visit A-Train, the Canadian Honey Badger, and possibly Zuby at Area 51 in Messalonia, Michigan.
For sure. I'll be there for sure.
October 20th, guys, you can get Chase. He'll be generaling the Spartans at the Fox Brother in Virginia Beach as well. And October 20th and 21st, see A-Train, again the Honey Badger, and Swami Greg at Big Indian Paintball in Perry, Georgia.
And J-Hub.
Oh, yeah?
That's her house.
Well, until she sends me submissions to Behind the Bunker, we'll just say that you guys are going to be there. We'll push your side.
Persona non grata.
So there we go. Jamie, then. You can call, and you've got my Skype number. I see you're there. And then November 8th, join myself, A-Train, Colonel Mustard, and many more. I don't know who else is coming, but to fill the gap. So definitely come out and join us. And if you would like to see Behind the Bunker at your field, get a hold of us at show@behindthebunker.com. Now, guys, why don't we zip on over real quick? And we're going to watch Track 21 and Skeletor's video of Blast Camp Recap. Check it out.
So, what do you think, A-Train?
I don't know. We just got done with Blast Camp, the Viper scenario, and I'm lost on what to do for a video, man.
Incredible. Where do we start? The teams?
Oh, man, there was Team Defiant. Did you see what those guys were doing with the action track chairs?
Incredible. Oh, hey, and what about the veteran?
Aim, fire! Left, face, freeze it, heart.
Through the perilous fight.
Oh, and we can't forget it was a Viper event.
Unbelievably well written. Use total use of the field. I mean, the gunfights alone.
So we are here thinking about this thing here, no doubt.
We'll be right back.
when you talk about the field and heroes, man, this ref staff?
Oh, man. Incredible.
Go! What about this field, man?
Virgil Frey?
Yeah.
Blast Camp, the owner. Tell us the history about this field.
Well, this is actually a decommissioned Army base from the Cold War. It's Nike Missile Base C-47.
Nice.
Since 1984, we've been on the Department of Interior's Registry of Historic Places. It's a lot to say, but it's a cool thing.
This place is a cool thing. And you picked this business up 3 years ago, right?
September 11th of 09. Nice.
Now, you have totally 180'd this field.
You know, Train, the old guys had it for 21 years, and I give them a lot of credit. They started in 1988 when the sport was just starting to grow. You know, give them a lot of credit. But after that long, they let it go. You know, their heart wasn't into it. I came back in, cleaned it up, gave it some TLC, focus on the customer, and it's been a big
nice.
Win for me.
When you bought this place, you cannot even stand here and tell me that you don't want to play here as a player.
Absolutely. You walk in, you see those satellite towers. It just gets your juices flowing, man. You want to be out there playing.
Thank you so much for having us. We got to tell the kids, you can come here. It is affordable and fun.
Awesome.
Thanks, man.
Thank you, Trent.
I'm still at a loss. I don't know where to begin.
I don't know. There's so much good stuff.
Well, you got all the cool game footage.
Yes.
So they can check that out on your channel.
Oh, yeah.
Right there.
Right there.
There are some who say there are so many things I need.
The one thing we have to agree on, and I'm sure we do, is that Blast Camp is Skeletor 262 and Track 21 certified legit.
Oh, yeah.
This is a place you have got to put on your to-do list.
Without a doubt. Without a doubt. And even if it's not your first to-do, it's come back again and again.
And again and again.
Yes, sir.
And call us. We want to come play it again.
Yes.
And we'd love to have you out. But listen, I got to come up with something.
You know, you'll figure it out, A-Train.
All right. Thanks, Skeletor.
Mm-hmm.
That's
the Team Tackle Social, you're watching Behind the Bunker.
All right, we're going to go to the studio for a second, or the production booth. Matt wants to just humbly apologize to A-Train for cutting off the end of his video.
Yeah, I did that.
That's all right.
If Matt wasn't pushing the buttons tonight, he'd be
in jail.
In Studio GA. Studio J.
Studio Gavin is
very
what
nice.
We're call it.
So guys, I want to say thank you very much to everyone that's watching that's new tonight. I keep seeing all these people new in the chat form. We've hit some record numbers tonight as well. And thanks to all the people that are new watching from PRZ and Blast Camp. We've seen those guys starting this week.
Those videos are coming next week too.
I hear there's another Blast Camp video from Skeletor.
Yep.
And there's a PRZ video coming next week from you guys, right?
We went through the footage today and never left the house. We skipped lunch.
A lot of footage.
Now, speaking of footage, Matt, let's go through these last four pictures that we had down here. There's just a couple of videos that I saw real quick. Tell us about these.
That's the owner and his grandson. Tim is absolutely one of the kindest folks and most generous people and made them new watchers. That's Mamisha Gangsters and all the Americans that came up. Smash, Miss Cat Shack, Sarah, Justin from Crooked Concepts and Mad Frog getting ready to go out.
That come and ride the train
again. It's choo, another choo. One of those. Yeah,
I
where I said
the train a coming.
You gotta watch Zuby. I said cover my right side, and apparently
he's covering all sorts of sides.
Yeah,
yeah. Now your barrel is pointing down. I saw Zuby.
And that, I think, is snarky because of the tiger stripe. But no, that's Zuby, man. He's totally legit. It was really nice. And he'll tell you, it was nice to meet all the fans of the show and the watchers. I see you guys all in the chat. I see what you're doing. They've cuffed my hands. I don't have a keyboard to say hi. But everybody out there, Paul and Mouse and everybody that came out, we'll see you on the show. And that's what this interactive paintball show is for. And we'll try to come back out again for sure.
Absolutely. And that's what it is. This is truly an interactive show, guys, and it's always open. So if you have any sort of submissions that you want to put in, you want to talk to us, send us stuff on Facebook, email, anything like that, definitely do so. But what I'm going to do, guys, is I'm going to say our final goodbyes to everybody. Jack, can I get you up here? Right after our farewells, guys, stay tuned. We're going to play Skeletor's Streetball video to sign our way out. The main studio, Studio B, Jack is going to give us parting gifts. Let's give a parting gift to A-Train and Chris Hazard for being in. Chris Hazard, the Canadian Honey Badger, thank you very much.
Not in the chat, by the way. That was an imposter.
Yeah. Oh, well, thank you very much. I just want me to pass this right down.
So guys, thanks to our sponsors at Empire Paintball. Oh, we're hooking you guys up with some brand
fantastic.
New duplexes. So thank you very much.
Wow, you can't even get these.
No, these are pretty super limited right now. I don't even think Americans have it.
Pretty
I guess
cool.
They do, actually. And then we'll also give one to Sarah.
No.
Absolutely. Wear them in good health, guys. Thank you for being on the show. Josh, any last final words you'd like to say?
I'd like to give a shout out to Juggernaut. Thanks a lot for the amazing stuff on the weekend. It was great. Thanks to everyone at PRZ. Fantastic field. I loved every minute
Sunny
of it.
Lopez.
Sunny Lopez.
If you guys have any posters you want added on to Behind the Bunker, send them to show@behindthebunker.com and we'll be sure to throw them up.
Very good. Joe.
Custom Corner, if anybody has any that's customized, they've done up with medical tape or cut or modified or painted or just bought and they like, send it into Custom Corner. That's Show It Behind the Bunker. Send your name and where you play and where you're from, and we'll ask.
Yeah. Gavin.
Two things. If you're on a team and you want to get some publicity, you want to get yourself on the intranet, send it to showitbehindthebunker.com. Brief bio, some photos, videos, great, and we'll put it on the team feature. Also, something's really bothering you about the sport of paintball, same address, folks, showitbehindthebunker.com, and we'll put it on for what's up with that?
You didn't use grind your gears.
Grind your gears, jam your hopper.
Yeah. In studio, Junior Barrel. On the couch, A-Train and Chris Hazard, thank you very, very, very much for coming in tonight. Thank you, as always, for being in.
Pebbles.
Yes, and Pebbles
and
as well.
CC.
And what are you, anything, where are you going to be, A-Train? Where can people find you?
I will actually be playing at my home field a little bit. Got some things I'm going to try to test out, some new products. But you're going to catch us at Mancelona for Area 51. Definitely check out that Facebook page. Yeah, it's going to be fantastic. Chris will be there. And
absolutely.
Then, Chris, you can tell them where we're going to in October.
We're going to go to Georgia to play against J-Hub. That's going to be an awesome game. That's big Indian paintball. Yeah.
And the loser has to go in an apron and do what?
Cook in the kitchen.
That's right.
Ain't gonna be us.
Sandwiches.
Nope. I ain't making no sandwiches. So.
Heck no.
But all these games are great. We worked really hard with the fields and.
Are you gonna make sandwiches or sandwiches?
I'm not making a damn sandwich.
They're gonna be making us sandwiches.
Right.
Very nice. And where can we find your videos?
Just hit us up on Facebook. We actually like to talk to you and tag your friends in the photos from the events. So you can find that facebook.com/ATrainPB, or you can look for
the Canadian Honey Badger on Facebook also.
Yeah.
Or can they find Track 20 on the YouTube? Or
yeah, you can link it up from there. It's ATrainTZB or TZB.
Ooh, very nice. TZB, we'll put up all the links on our chat forum. Thanks to Sarah, Justin, and Bill. All the way from Michigan, thank you for joining us. I hope you enjoyed being here on the show. How fantastic was it?
This was great. We're on it. We're not just watching it. We're on it. I've had a good time. Yeah.
I'm calling Bravo Sierra. I apologize. No, I'm calling Bravo Sierra.
All right, we had fun.
Yeah, because where he watches from is his hot tub.
It's a regular Monday date night with the wife, yes. Yeah.
So at this hour of the night, there'd be some raisins, right? As your snack.
Ooh.
Jeez.
But can people have raisins as snacks?
Yeah.
All right, guys. So with that, I'm being told we need to go. So thank you very, very much for watching the show. Justin, what's your company?
Crooked Concepts.
Look at that, under the wire. We just got that in. And what does Crooked Concepts do?
Vinyls, banners, t-shirts, team gear. If you guys ever see me
on stretchy shirts?
Everything I'm wearing.
Very nice. And guys, we'll put up their link on our Facebook page for Behind the Bunker, and you can follow them as well. So guys, check it out. Thank you to everybody in the studio tonight. Thank you to all you guys that are watching. We'll see you here every Monday night at 8 o'clock at Behind the Bunker. Yeah.
out there and play with all the HK guys. We're going to have a great time. What do you think? Speechless.
HTML.com and PaintballExplosion.com. Thanks, guys. Thanks.